We shall calculate electric potential due to the electric dipole. What is the dipole? Already we know that. Two equal and opposite separation, two equal and opposite charges are at a fixed separation, then that arrangement is said to be electric dipole. The arrangement in which equal and opposite charges are at a fixed separation is called electric dipole. Now the behavior of the electric dipole can be explained through electric dipole moment. That electric dipole moment is defined as the product of charge and the separation of the two charges is called electric dipole moment. Now electric dipole moment is a vector quantity whose direction from negative charge to the positive charge. Now here this is called electric dipole. This is minus charge. This is, what to say, positive charge. Now the positive charge at the point A and it is at the point B. Now this is called, what to say, axial line of the dipole. Now this is called, what to say, midpoint. The total separation is said to be, that is 2a. Now this distance is called a, this distance is called a. AB is 2a, OA is a, OB is b. Now we can calculate the electric potential on the axial line, or we can calculate the electric potential on the perpendicular bisector. Therefore, in a general way, we can calculate the electric potential at any point, right? Electric potential at any point. This point is called P. From the midpoint, this point P, as it is at a distance of R. Now, here, extend this line in the backward direction. In the backward direction, like this, right? Draw a perpendicular. This is the perpendicular. Now, from the negative charge, if you draw a perpendicular, that point is called M. Right? Draw a perpendicular, that is called, what to say, N. Now, right, connect these lines also. These lines. Connect PB also. Right, now, due to the negative charge, there is a potential at P. Due to the positive charge, there is a potential at P point. Now, right, due to positive charge, the potential is V1. V1 is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into, what is the charge, Q, by what is the distance? Distance is equals to BP. Next. Therefore, due to negative charge, what is the potential at the point P? V2 is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into, that is minus Q by, what to say, AP. Now, this is called your second equation. This is called your third equation. Due to the positive charge, the potential at the point P, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by BP. Due to the negative charge, the potential at the point P, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught minus Q by AP. Now, due to the electric dipole, what is the potential? Due to the electric dipole, what is the potential? V is equals to V1 plus V2. Therefore, V is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, Q and Q, both are common, Q by, that is 4 pi epsilon naught, Q by 4 pi epsilon naught, right, 1 by BP, that is minus 1 by, that is AP. Now this is called your third equation, right? Now you want to calculate BP value, you want to calculate AP value, then substitute those values, you will get the answer. Now, in order to calculate BP and AP, let us consider that dipole is, dipole is smaller, right? Now, as the dipole is smaller, already we have drawn perpendiculars from A. What is the perpendicular? AM. From the B, what is the perpendicular? BN. Right? As whenever the dipole is very small or smaller, that is PA, that is, or AP, that is AP is nothing but, what to say, MP. Right? Now, next one, that what to say, BP is equals to, the next one, BP is equals to, what to say, that is PN, right? Whenever the dipole is very smaller, that is PA is equals to PM. Whenever the dipole is very smaller, PB is equals to PN, right? Now, therefore, AP is equals to MP, BP is equals to PN. Now, here in this case, what is AP, what is MP, what is AP? Now, MP is equals to, what to say, PO plus OM. That is PO plus OM. Now, next one. What is PN? What is PN is equals to PO minus OM. PN is equals to PO minus ON. Therefore, PO minus ON. Right? Now, what is PO? What is PO? PO is equals to R plus PO R minus. What is the value of OM? What is the value of ON? Now, from the triangles. Now, let us consider this is the perpendicular triangle. Now, this is the perpendicular triangle. Now this is called a line connecting between the midpoint of the dipole to the point where we are connecting the, we are calculating the potential. Now this angle is theta and again this angle also theta. Now let us consider this is the perpendicular triangle. This is the perpendicular triangle. Now this is the perpendicular triangle. Now there is a perpendicular, here is the perpendicular, there is a point O and there is a point B. And there is a point N. Now this is called, what to say, A. Now this is the angle theta, right? This will become as a, right, opposite side. This will become as a hypotenuse. This will become as a adjacent side. Now A is resolved into two components, A cos theta and A sin theta. Therefore, now in this case, ON is equals to A cos theta. Now, in the same way, there is another triangle, that is, this is AO. Now, this is a perpendicular triangle. This is the perpendicular triangle. Now, like this. Now, this is called, what to say, perpendicular. This is the perpendicular. This is called A. Now this is called, what to say, theta. Now theta opposite. This is called opposite side. This is called hypotenuse. Now this is called, what to say, adjacent side. Now again, because this is adjacent side, OM is equals to, what to say, A cos theta. Now, therefore, OM is equals to A cos theta. Now ON is equals to again A cos theta. Therefore, these are represented by fourth equation. Now, equation number 4 is in substituted 3. That is 4 is in, that is 3 equation. Now, V is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, 1 by, that is BP. What is BP? BP is equals to R minus A cos theta minus 1 by AP is equals to R plus A cos theta Now that equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into, now LCM we are taking r minus a cos theta, right, into r plus a cos theta, right, now right r plus a cos theta minus r minus a cos theta, right, now right v is equals to, right, v is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into, right, r plus a cos theta, r plus a cos theta, right, that is minus r, minus r, minus into minus plus, that is a cos theta by, here in this case, a minus b, a plus b, right, a square minus b square, therefore r square minus a square cos square theta, now minus r plus r gets cancelled, therefore v is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, now that is here we forgotten, here q is there, here is also q is there, here is also q is there, here is also q is there, now here is also q is there, now a cos theta, a cos theta, that equals to 2a cos theta by, that is r square minus a square, that is cos square theta. Now here this equation may be termed as, that is q into 2a rearranged as a cos theta by 4 pi epsilon naught into r square minus a square cos square theta. Now that equals to, right, q into 2a, q into 2a is called dipole moment, therefore this is called dipole moment p into, that is cos theta by 4 pi epsilon naught, here r square minus a square cos square theta. Now already we consider that dipole is smaller, as the dipole is smaller, right, as the dipole is small, as the dipole is small, dipole is small, as the dipole is small, therefore a is less than r, as the a is less than r, this term a square cos square theta can be neglected, can be neglected, right, now okay, whenever this term is going to be neglected, therefore r square minus a square cos square theta, right, nearly equals to r square, therefore now here in this case v is equals to, that is p cos theta, p cos theta by 4 pi epsilon naught r square minus a square cos square theta is nearly equals to, that is r square, therefore this is the potential at a point p which is at a distance of r from the midpoint of the electric dipole. Now here in this case, due to a point charge, due to a point charge, v is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r, therefore potential is inversely proportional to r with respect to the point charge, with respect to the point charge, the potential v is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r, potential is inversely proportional to the distance, but in the case of electric dipole, right, now potential is inversely proportional to the square of the distance, in the case of dipole potential is inversely proportional to the square of the distance. Now what is the general formula? V is equals to p cos theta by 4 pi epsilon naught into r square. Now here is the theta, now this is the line connecting, this is the general formula, this general formula can be converted into, right, that to calculate the potential on the axial line, to calculate the potential on the equatorial line, for axial line, for axial line, for axial line. For axial line, now this is the line connecting between midpoint of the dipole to the point. This is the line. Now for axial line, the theta will be equals to 0. Therefore, for axial line theta equals to 0, then the potential is equals to V is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P by cos theta, cos 0. Cos 0 is equals to 1, therefore P by R square. Now for perpendicular bisector, for perpendicular bisector, now this is the line. For perpendicular bisector, the line becomes like this. Line becomes like this, theta is equals to, what to say, 90 degrees, thereby V is equals to, right, P cos theta, cos 90 is equals to 0, therefore potential is said to be 0. On the axial line, the potential V is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P by R square. On the perpendicular bisector, the potential is said to be 0. Therefore, this is the potential due to the electric dipole.